Hey everyone, Jason here. Today I'm excited to show you the latest progress on my LEGO Mosaic printer project. If you missed the first video, you can find it on my channel or in the description below or on one of these new HyperCard thingies. Today I'm going to show you the supply system I designed for it. But before we get into that, as you can see, I have mounted the printing arm on another set of gear racks so that it can move in two dimensions. And I'm really excited to show you what it can do. So let's jump right in and see it in action. So this program just prints a simple test pattern. It does take a few minutes, but I'll speed up the video through most of it. Here we go. So there you have it. It's not really that interesting a mosaic per se, but it does test the full range of the printer and it actually works, which I think is pretty awesome. So let's take a look at the supply. I obviously went with a gravity-based feeding mechanism, which is pretty much the simplest you can get. There's no moving parts other than the pieces themselves, and gravity does all the work for you. So I have a standalone model here to show you exactly how it works. And the key piece for this is this inverted arch, which gives a nice smooth transition from the plates stacked on their sides to them laying on their bottom so that the printer head can come and pick them up from the front. And every time it does that, gravity causes them all to come down further, and the next piece replaces it. It's extremely simple and very reliable. I also built this convenient little filling tray, which makes it really easy to replenish a color. It's much easier than adding them in one by one. Right now the supply can hold about 180 plates, which is obviously not enough to completely fill a 16 by 16 mosaic. So now that I know it works, I will have to expand it. I'll probably try and put twice as many columns and make it twice as high, so there'll be lots of plates available in different colors. I really appreciate all the comments people left on the first video. A lot of people were asking what I used to program it, and for the first prototype, I was just using the graphical programming environment that came with the EV3. For this prototype and moving forward, I definitely need something a little bit more sophisticated. So I started trying RobotC, which is a third-party C programming environment for it. So far I've been pretty impressed with it. Seems to work quite well. So I'll probably continue to use that for the rest of the project. One thing I would really like to have for this machine is actually a cool name for it. Right now I've just been calling it the LEGO Mosaic Printer, which, although descriptive, is really not that cool. So if you have any good ideas for a name for it, I would love to hear them. Leave a comment. As I said, I do need to expand the supply to be able to provide more plates, but I kind of already know that that works. So the next thing I'm going to be working on is the scanning aspect of it. So playing around with the color sensor and trying to scan some kind of source image. I'm not sure how much time I'll have over the next week to work on this, so maybe another couple of weeks before the next progress video. If you have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear them. As usual, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, keep on building, and I will see you in a couple of weeks or so.